It's about that time of day again. My name is Joseph. Tuesday evening, November 7th. Welcome back to your nightly newsletter. We're covering crude oil, S&P, Nasdaq, gold, and euro this evening. Crude is range-bound ahead of tomorrow's weekly inventory report. So my plan is to buy low, sell high, focus on failures before the news is released tomorrow morning. The S&P is range-bound as well, and the sellers have now tried twice to break out to the downside. So I'm watching to see if these sellers fail for a move back up into the range, or if they're successful, I'm looking to sell down to yesterday's low tomorrow morning. The Nasdaq is also range-bound and sideways this evening, telling me to focus on failures, sell high, buy low, and avoid that middle tomorrow morning. Gold is bearish and rotating or trying to rotate off the high of a channel, but we had a key support trend line for the most reliable selling opportunities tomorrow. The euro is also bearish with a big old flag pattern tonight, so my plan is to look for buyer failures up above the high, up in the battle zone, with a target going back down to this morning's low. As you heard me say, we got a bunch of range-bound markets to work with tomorrow, which always gives us a clear trading strategy for a great Wednesday session. I got a great newsletter in store for you guys, plenty of opportunities setting up for hump day session tomorrow, and of course, before I jump in and take a look at those charts tonight, I do want to remind you, the only place to watch the full-length version of our video is here on our blog at sidewaysmarkets.com. If you're watching the video right now on our YouTube channel, it's only a small snippet on the YouTube channel. If you want to watch the full-length version, go into the description of that YouTube video. In the description, you'll find the link. Follow that link over here to sidewaysmarkets.com and watch the full-length version. While you're here, don't forget, join the mailing list. I'll send you an email every evening when our nightly newsletter goes live. Follow me on social, lower left-hand corner. Pick whatever your favorite flavor of choice and follow me throughout the week. I'm always posting important charts, links, and updates throughout the week on my many different social media channels. You can also, of course, don't forget to grab those charts from tonight's video. Have them ready on your computer for tomorrow. How easy is that? All the charts from tonight's video, have them ready on your computer for tomorrow. Follow that link below the video here on the blog. And don't forget, come out and join me tomorrow. Grab that free pass in the upper right-hand corner if you're not a member here at School of Trade. Grab that free pass. Come join me as a guest in the trade room this week. You're going to learn more with me for free 99 on that free pass than you will anywhere else on the interwebs. I can pretty much guarantee that. And don't forget, if you have any questions, you can always type those questions in. Hit me up on live support. I'll be there to answer your questions every step of the way. Having a great day here so far. Hope you guys are too. Big, big, choppy session here today. And of course, before we jump into those charts for tomorrow, let's take a look at the calendar here for Wednesday, November the 8th. As we look at tomorrow, of course, being a Wednesday, before we jump in, though, we do have some major news tonight in the overnight Asian session. We get merchandise trade from our good friends in China. So if you trade in the overnight Asian session, please be aware of that market moving event. Tomorrow morning, as you can see, there really isn't a lot here. Not much here coming out of London. Really, we go right down to that 8:30 housing starts tomorrow morning. Don't forget, they export a lot of black gold out of our friends in the north. So housing starts always have a little bit of an edge on crude oil futures. And then, of course, don't forget, we got the petroleum status report tomorrow morning at 10:30 a.m. That's pretty much the only news we got to worry about tomorrow. So not a lot on the schedule overall tomorrow morning. The big news, of course, coming for crude oil traders at 10:30 a.m. Eastern time. There are two things I always want to remind you about the inventory report. One is going to be anything after 10 a.m. Eastern time, you've really got to be careful on Wednesdays if you're trading oil. My cutoff is 10:15, 15 minutes before that number comes out. But again, I always tell my clients, just be aware, anything after 10 a.m. on Wednesday mornings ahead of that 10:30 inventory report, usually the market slows down pretty good, right? And we don't really get a lot after that. So if it's moving, you can still trade it. But I always recommend, as of 10 a.m., start thinking about winding it down ahead of that inventory report at 10:30. And then also, don't forget, I'm posting my support and resistance levels. They'll be used for tomorrow's session. You can find those support and resistance levels. I sent them out to my Twitter, Facebook, and StockTwits family earlier on this afternoon. If you didn't get those support levels, right, those support and resistance levels on my social media channel earlier on today, I'm going to have them posted for you below the video tonight on the blog. So go to Sideways Markets, scroll down. There's a link that says click here to read more, right? Open that link up and you'll see the full text transcript for tonight's video, right? You can find those support and resistance levels. So again, don't forget, kind of the unofficial cutoff tomorrow around 10 a.m. Eastern time. Just watch things after 10 a.m. My official cutoff is 10:15. And then, of course, those support and resistance levels, again, you'll find them below the video tonight on the blog at sidewaysmarkets.com. Or if you follow me on social media, I sent those out a few hours ago. That's about all we got to worry about for tomorrow, right? Again, major news tomorrow. Pretty much it's all petroleum status reports, all with the inventory report tomorrow morning. And, of course, we'll come back and take a look at Thursday's session in tomorrow night's newsletter. So tomorrow, Wednesday morning, hump day, right, inventory day here on crude oil. Let's start tonight with crude oil here. We got crude, S&P, we'll go Nasdaq, we'll wrap up there on the gold and the euro. First three charts tonight are range-bound, a lot of range-bound markets as we go into Wednesday's session. Overall, it was a real choppy, sloppy session across the board. We had that OPEC global or world outlook report that was due out this morning. That seemed to shake things up a little bit, you know, between 9:30 and 11 o'clock. And as you can see here, it didn't get much easier as the day developed. Had a pretty good day today. It was a range day on crude oil. So crude is range bound ahead of tomorrow's weekly inventory report, which tells me to focus on failures using the two try rule tomorrow morning while watching the time ahead of the weekly news report. Remember, tomorrow's inventory day, which really in my mind means anything can happen. And my cutoff is 10:15 Eastern time before that news is released. Now you can see here I've posted those, right, support and resistance levels for tomorrow, right? You can either write those down right now or you can just, again, scroll down on the blog at Sideways Markets and you'll find, right, those SR levels ready to go for tomorrow. I'll obviously be using these tomorrow with all of our traders in the trade room. Looking at the chart right now, again, day started off as a range, but you'll notice they've kind of shifted that range lower a little bit, right? So balance appears to be moving lower. We get this, of course, lower lows, lower highs. So, you know, right now the market, although we're coming out of that big run, right, from earlier on this week, all of a sudden now this market's starting to look a little bit heavy here. Now, we're range bound, bear market moving lower into a trading range. I think you're probably going to have both sides of this market playing outside of this range. Anytime I have a trading range, I always know I want to sell high, I want to buy low, I want to avoid the middle, right? Don't fiddle with the middle, right? So that's the hard part. The hard part is when you're in the middle of the range, you want to stay away from the middle of that trading range. Then I want to focus on failures, right? So as we go up above the top of the range, I'm looking left, I'm finding prior swings. Those create my battle zone. I want to go up outside the range. And what I'm hoping that buyers will try to buy this pullback. Then, knowing that it's a bear bias going into that trading range, I'm looking for an area where the buyers, again, strong break up, that will get a lot of buyers thinking this market is bullish. I'm hoping they try to buy that pullback, because if they do, now I know where their stops are going to be and I can sell right into those stops, right? Those buyers will become sellers once the market starts moving lower, right? It'll trap them on the wrong side of the market. I call this the two try rule. One try, two try. You've probably seen previous videos on my newsletter regarding that two try rule. In fact, early last week, right, I sent out the most recent edition of our two try rule newsletter. So that's the two try rule. And again, focusing on buyer failures, up, buyer failure, and back down in. Now, if those buyers are successful at holding that pullback and running, well, now we have a problem because now we're back up to retest the high. So it really doesn't get very easy here for the buyers, right? Again, price goes up, one try, two try, failure, back down in. That's the easy one. If they're successful and we run up back to those highs, I'm now going to go looking for a new bull channel, try to find this as support, try to find that as support, and I'll try to get in long using a trap, right? Basically, whenever we find ourselves in a position where the only option is to buy high, I always try to stay away from buying high, and I try to focus my energy, right, on buying with traps, right? If you haven't taken my free trial yet, make sure you join my free trial, take my free trial, and you'll learn more about all of these patterns, one of which are called traps. So that's the scenario as the price goes higher. Now, as the price goes lower, you'll notice we already have this first move down. So that's considered the first try. As long as we don't get back to 57.28, we still have a second try in play. So one try, two try, and then back up in. Or let's say we go one back up to the high, now it resets the count, right? So now it's one try, two try, and back up in we go from there, right? So bears try to break things out. That strong move down will likely have sellers trying to sell the breakout, right? The pullback. This obviously now tells me where their stops are. And as soon as I see those stops start to get threatened, I know those sellers, one try, two try, are probably going to bail and give me a buying opportunity, right, as they fail. So a really, really easy strategy for a range-bound market: sell the high, buy the low, focus on failures using that two-try rule, and avoid the middle. Also, too, and again, we talked about this earlier, if the buyers are successful, we got to be careful up here. If the sellers are successful, same thing, right? Now we run right into a measured move. So if we do find ourselves successful there, then what I'll do is I'll find some resistance. I'll look for that move up, right, and try to sell. Again, trap, to the sell high, right, with that trap going back down to that low. And, of course, tomorrow's an inventory day, so who knows what tomorrow will bring, closer to 10:15, 10:30. If we do end up collapsing here, oh boy, that prior low of day is all the way down at 55.66. It's a bit of a pipe dream right now, but tomorrow's inventory day, so you never know what we're going to get. Sellers want to get back down to yesterday's low. It's a big, big move down. Buyers want to get back up to retest the high. In the meantime, though, I'm looking for failures to buy low, sell high, right, using that two-try rule here tomorrow. And again, don't forget to watch those support and resistance levels, right, because they will be little tiny speed bumps along the way. Speaking of speed bumps, let's get on to another really kind of rough around the edges market today, another range-bound market. S&P is range-bound, and trying to complete the two-try rule below the lows, which tells me the next few hours will most likely make or break this trading range going into tomorrow's session. This is the second try to break out of this range, and if the sellers can show us some strength, I'm looking for continuation down to yesterday's low. If the sellers can't run this price lower, then obviously we're looking for, right, that seller failure back into the moving average for a move back up to fill that gap at the top of the range. This is quite the interesting chart here. You'll notice we have clearly double tops, double bottoms, right? That creates the trading range, right? You'll notice now we get this strong breakout, right, and the move down, right? That strong move down went all the way down, right, to that double down support level coming off of that high. Now, there's a little bit of interpretation that may be in play here right now. For example, we may have this being used, one try, two try. That may be enough right there to give the bears the control that they need. The problem, though, is if the bears did take control right there, this move right here would have gone right back down to retest that low. So I'm leaning on the side of using this as more of a major two try, and that is one try, two try, and then back up from there. Really, I think it all comes down to what happens here in the next few hours. If we do make our move back up, I'm looking for that seller failure off the moving average, kind of a nested two try, right? A failure off that moving average, again, anticipating that sellers are going to try to sell that pullback to the moving average and look for that trade going back up into that range. We have three different markets that are range bound right now, right? So make sure, right, you learn that range bound strategy. Make sure that you wait for those fake out breakouts, that two try rule, fade those breakouts, avoid that middle. And don't forget, right, don't forget, we may see some strong breaks out of that range tomorrow because of markets like crude oil, gold, S&P, who have those big, big moves earlier on in the week. Before I let you guys go, don't forget, if you want to learn more about everything that it means to be a client here at School of Trade, including all of our strategies, right? Don't forget, we get a great free trial on the homepage of our website. If you're on the YouTube channel right now, there are links in the description of that YouTube video. Follow those links over here to the website, schooloftrade.com, and grab a copy of your free trial. While you're here, don't forget, check out our beginner, intermediate, and advanced classes that we can learn more about what's included with each level of membership. And I'm always here to help. If you guys have any questions, hit me up on live support. I'm available 24/7, 365 on the right-hand side of the website. It's been a great week so far. Get some sleep tonight, all right? We're definitely, I can definitely feel that little bit of a hangover from the daylight savings time shift on Sunday morning. So definitely try to catch up on some sleep, right? Stay with me tomorrow morning in the trade room. I'll see you guys 8 o'clock Eastern time. Be well out there. Be nice to each other and be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye.